Hello everyone, I am Sahithi. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new to this channel, I am here to explain you the tough topics of biology for NEET and also to share my NEET experiences with you all. Without wasting any more time, let's dive into the video. Till now we have seen glycolysis and fermentation, where partial oxidation of glucose takes place. And there is very little amount of energy liberated in this process. Now we will see aerobic respiration. For the aerobic respiration to take place, pyruvic acid formed in the cytoplasm during glycolysis should be transported to the mitochondria. First, it is transported to the matrix of the mitochondria where link reaction take place. Now, coming to the link reaction, it is also called as intermediate reaction. Here, pyruvic acid gets converts to acetyl coenzyme A by using the enzyme pyruvic dehydrogenase. So, how to remember the enzyme name? Pyruvic means pyruvic acid. Dehydrogenase means removal of hydrogens from pyruvic acid. For this enzyme to work, it requires many coenzymes like coenzyme A, NAD+. For the activation of pyruvic dehydrogenase, it also requires Mg+2. This step is called as oxidative decarboxylation. Oxidative is nothing but removal of hydrogens. Here, hydrogens are removed from pyruvic acid and gets added to NAD+ and forms NADH+H+. Decarboxylation is nothing but removal of carbon dioxide. That is why acetyl coenzyme A have two carbons instead of three carbons of pyruvic acid. Now we will see a question. How many NADH+H+ are formed in the link reaction? First, from one pyruvic acid. Just now we have seen the link reaction. It is one NADH+H+. If they ask from one glucose molecule, it means once glycolysis has taken place. So in glycolysis, we get two pyruvic acids. So in the link reaction, two pyruvic acid gets converts to two acetyl coenzymes A, releasing two NADH+H+. So the answer is two.
Now coming to the Krebs cycle, it is explained by the scientist Hans Krebs. So the name Krebs cycle. It is a cyclic pathway, unlike glycolysis. Glycolysis is a linear process. It also occurs in matrix of the mitochondria, same like link reaction. It is also called by many other names like tricarboxylic acid cycle, organic acid cycle.
Now coming to the Krebs cycle, acetyl coenzyme A formed in the link reaction starts condensation with oxaloacetic acid and water to form citric acid by using the enzyme citrate synthesis. Here a coenzyme A molecule is released. Further, citric acid isomerizes to isocitric acid. Isocitric acid undergoes oxidative decarboxylation to form alpha-ketoglutaric acid. Here NAD+ changes to NADH+H+. And a CO2 molecule is released. In the next step, alpha-ketoglutaric acid converts to succinyl coenzyme A by oxidative decarboxylation. Here also one CO2 is released and NAD+ converts to NADH+H+. In the next step, succinyl coenzyme A converts to succinic acid. This step is substrate level phosphorylation. Here a GTP molecule is released. In a coupled reaction, ADP converts to ATP. In the next step, succinic acid converts to fumaric acid. Here, unlike other steps, FAD+ changes to FADH2. Succinic dehydrogenase enzyme is used in this step. Fumaric acid changes to malic acid. Malic acid changes to oxaloacetic acid. And NAD+ changes to NADH+H+. In this way, the cycle continues. Now, coming to the number of carbons in each molecule. Acetyl coenzyme A condenses with oxaloacetic acid, so 2 plus 4 becomes 6 for citric acid. Isocitric acid also have 6 carbons, but alpha-ketoglutaric acid have 5 carbons because there is a release of carbon dioxide. Succinyl coenzyme A have 4 carbons because there is release of another CO2 molecule.
Here onward, succinic acid, fumaric acid, malic acid, oxaloacetic acid have same number of carbons as that of succinyl coenzyme A, that is 4 carbons. Now coming to few important points of Krebs cycle, there are 2 points where oxidative decarboxylation occurs. From isocitric acid to alpha ketoglutaric acid, from alpha ketoglutaric acid to succinyl coenzyme A. Second, there are 2 points where carbon dioxide is evolved. One is here and one is here. Third, there are 3 points where NADH++ are formed. One is here, second, and third. There is only one point in the whole cycle where FADH2 is formed, that is from succinic acid to fumaric acid. Another most important point is succinic dehydrogenase is present in the intermitochondrial membrane, whereas all the other enzymes like citrate synthesis and others, they are present in the matrix itself. But succinic dehydrogenase is present in the intermitochondrial membrane. Till now, I explain one round of Krebs cycle. In one round of Krebs cycle, the products are 3 NADH++, 2 CO2, 1 FADH2, 1 ATP. If they ask for 2 rounds of Krebs cycle, 6 NADH++, 4 CO2, 2 FADH2, 2 ATP. If they ask from 1 pyruvic acid, 4 NADH++, 3 CO2, 1 FADH2, 1 ATP.
You understood the concept now, but how to memorize the cycle? If you find a trick for this, you should again try to remember the trick. Instead, you can remember the cycle itself, right? So I don't prefer any trick for the cycle. Instead, I will share your tip. You revise and write it down on the paper daily for a week. Leave it for 3 days. On the 4th day, write it down on your own without referring. Try like this for the next 4th day. You will definitely remember the cycle. This is only called as spaced repetition. Like, share and subscribe to my channel for the further videos. In my next video, I will be coming up with electron transport system.